دكاترة عيون حكيم، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي، واجعل لي وزيرا من اهلي هارون اخي، اجدد به ازري واشركه في امري، كما سبحك كثيرا وذكرت كثيرا انك كنت بنا بصيرا. So we continue chapter 7 about digital logic design or logic circuits. We always speak about the calculator, right? So we understand why you are studying what you are studying. So when you use a calculator to add or subtract or whatever operation, say addition, when you hit 3 plus 6, what's happening inside?
It turns to BCD, it turns to binary.
Okay, so 3, whatever digits you hit here, it will be understood as 1010. Then what's next? How the calculator adds two numbers together in binary? This is done using logic circuit, logic design, like what we have seen last time. Look at this circuit. This circuit has two gates. What are these two gates?
AND OR and XOR.
This is called XOR. It has this, it's a special case of OR. We will explain it today. But we have two gates. This is a logic circuit that will perform the addition process. So what's the meaning of addition? If you need to add, say you need to add 101 plus 011. What's the meaning of this? What's 101 in decimal?
Three, two, five.
You should know this very quickly. Yeah. This 1, 2, 4, and so 4 plus 1 is 5. What's the other number?
Three.
So as if I'm adding 4 plus 3, which must be 7, right? Five. How does the calculator do this? What's 1 plus 1?
Zero.
1 plus 1 is 2, but we don't have 2, so it is 0 carry and the carry 1. Then 1 plus 1?
Zero.
0 and the carry 1. Then 1 plus 1?
Zero.
I think we have a mistake here. This is 5. So okay, sure. This is 5. This is 5 plus 3, which is 8. Okay? So what we end up by 1 plus 1 is 0 and the carry 1. The answer is, what's this answer?
Is
it. So for the calculator to do this, it needs to have two inputs. Every time we have two inputs, right? And how many outputs?
One.
Two outputs, sum and the carry. Remember here, 1 plus 1 is 0 and the carry 1. These are two outputs. So to perform this operation in the calculator, we need to have a truth table. A table that connects the input. The input is A plus B. And the output, sum and the carry. 0 plus 0 is 0 and the carry 0. 0 plus 1, 1 and the carry 0. 1 plus 0, 1 and the carry 0. 1 plus 1, 0 and the carry 1. These are the only four operation or four possibility we can have, right? Because we can have only two inputs. We can have more than two inputs. We can have A, B, C. Still, we will have sum and the carry. So, we need a circuit that has two inputs and two outputs to perform this operation. So to design a system, calculator, whatever, you need first to understand how does the system work. What you need from the system. For example, here we need to add two numbers. So you need to construct the table that will connect the input to the output. The table will tell you what is the output expected for each input. Okay? This is based on our understanding. Then what makes it? To design the circuit. Circuit means diodes, transistor, resistor. To design a hardware that will perform this operation. The circuit will be designed using logic gates. You need to design some logic gates that will take the two inputs and produce the two outputs based on the truth table, based on the circuit operation, right? The question is, we now understand how to build this table. This table based on the application, right? So we are adding two numbers, whatever application. Now, how can we draw the circuit from the truth table? How can we design this circuit? Whatever gates we have here, how can we implement the circuit based on the table? This is the question we need to answer today. And we need to design a calculator to add two numbers. Okay, Shabab? So what is the objective of the class? To design a logic circuit that will perform a certain application. That's it. If we understand this, then you can work as digital design. Yes.
What if it was 1 and carry 1? one,
yes, we can have another input here. You can have ABC. When you have ABC, you will have 1, 1, 1. It will give 1 and carry 1. Yeah, and this is actually this half adder. It's not full adder. Full adder will have 3 inputs. The full adder, but this is simple adder. Okay? Whatever application, we need to understand how can we build the circuit from the truth table. This is what a digital designer do. By the way, digital designer, one of the very highly paid job. يعني someone who designs this circuit, يعني might take above $120,000 a year. This is very simple, but he will design very complicated circuit. But what I say is digital design is very attractive job. So maybe you guys transfer from mechanical to electrical or digital design. You still can do this, even with mechanical engineering, you still can do this stuff. You can take a summer course to understand how to do this stuff. Okay, so let's go back to يعني now we have some idea what we need to do today. Let's continue the material. Last time we said that the three main gates, the three gates we know that can be used to implement any system are AND, NOT, or inverter, and OR. These are the three basic gates. Any circuit, any system, big computer can be designed using only the three gates. Okay? We will take now some more gates that's based on these gates. We will play with them. We will connect this guy with this guy, this guy with this guy to produce new gates. But the new gates are just يعني, based on these gates. So these are the three main gates. Okay, شباب? If you have 1, 0, 1, 0, what is the output?
0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1,
because this is A times B, or it should be AND. A and B should be 1 to have 1. If you have 1, what's the output?
0.
This inverter, not gate. Here, if you have 1, 0, what is the output?
1, 1, 1.
Either of them should be 1 to produce 1, or both of them could be 1. So these are the three main gates. What about if I block this guy with this guy? If I bring this, put it here. What's the new gate? So I will have what we call NAND. NAND is AND followed by inverter. Yeah, and if I bring this guy here, the new gate can be drawn like this, a simple one. So what's the meaning of this circle? Inverter. So instead of drawing the big ones, the triangle, we just add this guy. So the output is A times B, A and B, all inverted. What's the truth table? Truth table means I have the inputs. What is the output? Reverse of the AND. The AND will give you 0, 0, 0, 1. Now we have the reverse. The other gate is NOR. What's the meaning of NOR? OR followed by inverter. Still, this is not new. It's the same stuff. I brought them together. What is the truth table? Inverted of the OR. The OR gives you 0, 1, 1, 1. Now we have the inversion. Okay, Shabbat? So what I'm saying is these are the main basic gates where we can play with them to produce some new gates. As we have seen, this is NAND, NOR. NOR is A, OR, A plus B, inverted. We have another gate called, what's the name of this?
Buffer.
So if A is 1, output is 1. So do you remember something like this in OBAMP?
Amplifier, yes.
The amplifier that has unity gain, you remember? To give the same output. So what is the benefit of this? Usually it will give you the same output, but it delivers large current. Yeah, if we need to use this circuit to excite another circuit that needs a large current, so it can provide large current. Okay, or high input impedance like the op-amp. Yeah, and it is used to deliver some amount of current or some amount of voltage. We have a new gate, which is again modification of the OR gate. So the XOR, we will have this line. This look at this curve. What's the meaning of XOR? Look at the table. Look at the table. What's different between this and the OR? The OR, I have one here. Now I make this 0. Now, give it a name. Give a name for this operation.
Exclusive
OR. Only OR. 0, 1, 1, 0 will give 1. Only if either of them is 1. If both of them is 1, this is 0. So it's exclusive OR. XOR. Okay? So this means if the two inputs are different, output is high. If the two inputs are the same, output is low. Exclusive OR. Okay, شباب? What about if I have inverter here? Add inverter here. The new gate is It will be x null. Let's say with the x over. The x over. Can we write the equation? يعني what is q? Now please listen to me. This is very important. What is q? I need to write here an equation based on a and b. That will give this output. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, I need to write here some function. Some a prime b plus b. Something like this. I need to write something like this. That will give the same output for each case. How can I do it? This is a design. Now I'm doing design. Now I have some application that need to the application requires to produce this output based on this input. Application system. How can I design a circuit to produce this output? We need to write a Boolean expression. We need to write an equation. What's the equation? The equation is simply a b prime plus a prime b. Prime means like this. Yeah, you can write like this or like this. Okay, شباب. Let's make it same as book. So it is a b prime a prime b. Does this make sense? Does this equation really represent the output? Let's see. When a is zero, b is zero. What is the output? Zero, zero. This is zero, right? And here, zero. Zero plus zero is zero. Zero one. So a is zero, b is one. What's the output?
Zero.
This is zero, zero, one, this is zero. And here?
One.
So output is one. So this agree, this agree. If A and B, one, zero. What's one. Output?
One.
Zero. If A, one, B is one. This case, does this make sense?
Zero.
So it agree. Okay? So now we have somehow designed the circuit. Design the circuit means you write an equation that gives the same output each time. Okay? So what's the question now? How did I write this equation? How did I write this equation? This is a question here. How can you write an expression for an output of a system? Can anyone tell me? I will give three bonus if you tell me how did I write this equation. Yeah, the answer is on the board. The answer is here. The answer is here. How did I write this equation? Raise your hand. It takes some time to think. The answer is here, Shabbat. How did I write this equation to produce this output? And it agrees with all cases. Yes, Ya Omar.
I believe we look at the ones and analyze it how it comes. We know that the identity A, B prime equals to zero, if it's one or zero. So by that we write that.
Yes.
You're
on the way, but you still didn't see how can I write it. Why not A prime, B prime? Why not like this? Why not A prime, B prime? Yes, Muhammad.
From here, when they are the same, it should be zero. Mm. So A will be one, B will be zero. So both will be zero. When they are the same one.
Yes, Muhammad. Muhammad Al-Ali. Muhammad.
توقعنا لو كانت 0 1 1 0 فاول شيء موقع انفرتد، ثاني شيء انفرتد اللي هو بي، ثالث ران تصير انفرتد.
والاخير هذا 0. يعني ليتس ستارت، هاو ديد رايت ذس؟ واز ذا مينج اوف اي برايم بي؟ اي بي برايم اور اي برايم بي؟ يعني فروم وير اي جيت ذس؟
من الناتج اول شيء 0 1 تاخذ اي 0 وخلاص موقع انفرتد. اي بي اي بي ثم الثاني انفرتد لانها 1.
So A B prime from where?
من الناتج شو؟
Yeah. Which one?
Zero تصير خلاص نفسه. ما لازم
Yes answer. You are close. يعني you are getting closer step by step. I want you to get the answer actually. Yes answer.
عندنا أربعة أول اثنين zero zero four منها نفسها. ثاني zero one five تكون منها base. والثالثة واحد صفر تكون base والرابعة.
Yeah let me help you. Okay. You are also close. So here, Anas, the output is one. Look, I will focus on one. Okay? When the output is one, what is A and B? A is A prime, B is B, true B. Because it's 0. 0 means A prime. Okay? Yes. When B is 1, means B. Clear? Here, output is 1. What is A and B?
A,
B prime. Why A? Because A is 1. B is B prime. B is 0. Now add these two guys, it will give you the expression. Nice. You wanted to say this? He didn't say, he didn't say this. So it is, this is what we have here is sum SOB. What's SOB? Sum of product. Sum of product. This product, right? And this sum. This is the class. The class is how can you write an equation that represents the output of a certain system, whatever system. يعني first you should have the table. Then, what's the next step? Look at the ones, when the output is 1. Then write each input as expression as a product of all the variables. If the variable is 0, it means the prime. If the variable is 1, it is true value. Here, output is 1. So A, B prime. Then add one, add all of them. You might have more stuff. The equation will give you, will work with all cases. How does it work? Because here, what you have here, you have all, right? This means any one to be one, any term is one, will give you true value. The other guys will give zero for sure. The other guys will give zero. That's it. This is the class. The remaining is just some problems. Yes.
So, Dr. Why did you say it's A, B prime plus A prime B? The
step number one, Usama, huh? Yes. Step number one, Usama, you have this table. You have the other. So, step number one, look at the ones, when you have ones. For each output one, write the input. If the input is zero, it will be prime. So, A here is zero. Look at here, Osama. A is zero, so A prime. B is one, so B is true. Now, the other one, what is A? One. So, it's A, just A. B is zero, so B prime.
Okay, but we flip it to a row.
It will work only in this case. Yani you are here saying I can write A prime B. Yeah. It will work only in this case by coincidence, but it will not work with other cases. It has to be written this way. Okay? You get this?
Yes.
This is yani by chance be thought for him, but this is not the common case. Okay, Shabab, any question here? Yes. Only one. This is another. This is one method, by the way. The other method is to look at the zeros and write them as product of sum. I will explain this now. And we have two methods to write this equation, Shabab. Two methods. The first method, look at the ones. Next method is look at the zeros. It will be يعني, a little bit different. But it will give you also a similar expression. Okay, Shabab? Is it clear? So let's repeat. What is it? So now I need to write an equation that gives all the output for each case. What's the first step? First step, yeah.
Look at the ones.
Nay, first step. Look at the ones. Yeah. How many? Look, circle the ones. This is first step. Second step.
We put the real number for.
For each one, for each output one, write the input as product. Mm. Product means what should I write here?
A.
A. Prime B.
B.
A prime because A is zero. Look here. A is zero means A prime. B is one. B. Next, this is still second step. So first step, look at the ones. Second step, write the input for each one as product. Okay? Next step, then still second step. What then what should I write here, Anas? Ya Ben Naif.
A.
A.
And B
prime. B prime. This is step number two, Yashabab. Step number two is to write this expression. Step number three, add these guys. That's it. So the final answer is A prime B. Plus A, B prime. Easy?
Yes.
Before doing this, you must have the table. Okay? And the table based on your application. I could tell you to design traffic light, heating system, EC system, whatever system you need to understand how the system works, then write the equation. Once you write the equation, now we need to build the circuit. What's the next? Use the equation to draw some AND OR to get this equation, as we have seen last time. Next step is to build the circuit. Put the case together, as we did last time. That's it. So this is the expression that represents XOR. XOR, this is the same stuff. The symbol is like this. Look at this. This means X O. If you remove the circle, it will be O. تمام؟ This is X O. X O if you add inverter. What's the answer? A X O B. Inverter. That's it. And the truth table.
0 0 0.
When they are similar, it is high. When they are similar, high. Input is different, 0. Exclusive, exclusive, no, yes.
You said that we design the circuit after we get the equation. How do you get the truth table before we see the circuit?
I go to the truth table because I need an application that give height when the two inputs is different.
No, but in other applications, if I want to find the equation, I need to get the truth table. Where would I get the truth table if I don't have the circuit in front of me?
If I don't have the circuit? You will get the truth table based on the inputs, Omar. يعني see you need to design as I said something like the full order. Remember the order I have to design? Here I need to design a circuit to add two numbers. I understand that 0 plus 0 is 0 and carry 0. So this is the application says this. Then you have the table based on your application. Then you draw the circuit based on the table. Okay, before drawing the circuit you need to write the sum and the carry as equation. Then from the Boolean equation you design the circuit. It will be clear, Fahd. It will be clear now. We will have some problem. The three main gates are these guys, right? These are the three main gates. Can we get rid of them? Put them in the garbage? And replace all of them with NAND. Can a NAND gate replace all these gates? So the NAND will be used as AND, as inverter, as OR gate. Again, the question is, these are the three basic gates. We know nothing but these gates. Any circuit, any system in the world can be designed by these three gates. The question is, can we remove them, forget about them, and just use NAND?
Yes.
So design any system with the NAND only?
Yes.
How?
By the AB, just invert. By the NAND, also just invert. By the AB, using the DMARC as well.
Okay,
something
along the line what you are saying, Yom. Okay, so the question is, can we replace an inverter or with NAND gate?
Yes.
Let's see. What is, if you have NAND gate and you tie them together, say input together, make them one input. What's the output?
A.
A
inverted.
The output is A times A inverted. Right? This is NAND. You have AA here. So the output is AA inverted. What's the meaning of this? What's A times A? A. A times A is A. A. And A is A. Right? 1, 1 give 1. 1, 0, 0 give 0. So what's the answer here? A prime. So A will give you A prime, right?
Yes.
So what's the meaning? What is this? What is this gate? So I can use NAND as inverter. How? By tying the input together. So we get rid of one problem. The first problem is that inverter can be designed using NAND gate. Put them together, the output is A inverted. Tamam? What is the? Is this clear? So we don't need inverter. We can use just NAND. What is the output of this guy? How many NAND you have here? 3 NAND. Nothing else. No other gates. What is the output? What is the output here? Inverter. A prime. B prime. What is the output here?
A or B.
The output here is A prime, B prime, inverted. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Which is? You remember DeMorgan law?
Yes.
Three steps. First step,
AB.
Invert each variable. Right? Second step, and you become all. Third step, invert all. Remove this invert. Okay, Asama? What did you find out on your phone? So what are you saying, Asama? Are you saying, Asama, what is the output of this circuit you are saying? What's the output here? Here I have A, inverted A prime, B. This inverter, Osama, B prime. What's the output here, Osama? Listen. and inverted. So take this and invert it, which will be, it is A prime, B prime, all prime, which is A plus B. So what's happened? What is this? What does this mean? What is the whole thing? Or, this or. Or can be designed with three NAND gate. Inputs AB, output A plus B. So an or, we don't need or. We need just NAND. So this is the output here, ya shabab, A plus B. So the whole thing is or. The whole thing is not. Wait, wait. Is this clear? So we don't need inverter. We need only NAND, one NAND. Three NAND will act like or. If you have a NAND, NAND, I need to make this like AND. What should I do? Inverted. How can I invert it? We don't have inverted. We'll use this guy. So what's the output?
AB.
The output here is AB. Which is, the whole thing is AND. So one NAND will act as inverter. Three NAND will be OR. Two NAND will be AND. So don't use other guys. A NAND gate can do the job of any system in the world. This big computer can be designed using NAND only. Okay? This is the reason in when they build the ICs, the circuits, they only focus on NAND. Sometimes only focus on NAND. This is what we need. It will replace inverter or AND gate as well. Yes, if I.
Why would you use NAND when you, last class you said, we don't want to use a lot of gates because it costs money. So if you use NAND gate instead of all, we use three gates.
Actually, yeah, in IC fabrication, when you do the same job many times, it will be cheaper than designing different gates. You are getting this?
Yeah.
Like mass production, so you are building the same stuff every time. So you don't need to worry about other gates. Now we have one gate, we'll do the job. So you repeat the process in the circuit, the same process, so this might be cheaper if we use only NAND. Because you don't need to worry about other gates. You know the mass production, when you build the same stuff every time, so it doesn't cost. The biggest cost is the beginning, is to build one NAND. Then repeat it. This could be an answer, yeah. Maybe not the best answer, it could be easier. What's output here, Misha? What's output here?
AB.
AB? This NAND. So the output here is A, B, prime. How can I move the prime? Inverter, which is this guy. When you add inverter, AB prime will be, the answer here will be AB. So two NAND will act as AND gate. Okay, shabab? So as you can see, yani, we can play with these gates to produce nice stuff. So what's the answer here?
Yes.
What's the answer here, Hussein?
Yes.
Why yes? The one behind Abdul Hakim? Abdullah. عبد الحكيم, what's the answer?
Yes.
Why yes?
Because we
can do inverter using NAND. We can do OR using NAND. We can do AND using NAND. The three basic gates can be done. These gates, ya shabab. These are the three basic gates. This is the basic gates. All of them can be done using NAND. So, a NAND gate is enough to build any logic system, any logic circuit. Okay, shabab. I have three main gates. Can I put them in the garbage and use only NOR? Can NOR replace all of them?
Yes.
Yes. How? Again, we'll do the same. So, are NOR gates sufficient to realize any logic function, to build any logic function or any logic equation? The answer is, if I tie them together, what's the answer here? J, what's the output?
A plus A or
A? A plus A, this is all, right? It's all inverted, it's A plus A. Inverted, which is what?
A inverted.
A inverted, so this inverter. Tamam? What's your name? What's the output of Abdulatif? This is A plus B inverted?
Yes.
Then?
Then
this inverted again, it will give you A plus B.
A plus B.
So AB give A plus B. What is the whole thing?
OR.
So inverter is NOR. or is nor. How can I design or using nor? The next step, sorry, how can I design and using nor? It will be big a little bit. So what's output here? What's output here?
A prime.
B? B prime. What's output here? A prime plus B prime. All inverted. Which is what?
AB.
So the whole thing is AND. So inverter OR AND can be designed using NOR. So an OR gate is enough to build any system. Okay, Shabab? Any question? Any question? No.